many millions of Christians, millions of Muslims, and many, many, many Jews. Now tell us how many of you are here?
I'm not counting. Just because you don't need to count. Because the problem is, you're the one who's so obsessed with creating division in society. You're the one who wants to divide people up into chunks.
No, we don't. I just see people. We don't divide.
Yes, of course you do.
We are so nice. We don't divide.
You're standing here preaching how your thing is better than everyone else.
Let me tell you. We don't divide. Excuse me. We don't divide.
Who actually
cares? I don't know whether you're a fan.
That's the great thing about this British society.
But let me tell you,
we care.
Can you define what you meant by "use" when you pointed and spoke to this man?
Yeah.
You mentioned. You mentioned different races.
Yeah, he's racist, mate. That's the base.
He's racist.
No, I'm not racist.
Answer the man's question.
Yeah, don't worry.
Can you define when you refer to this man as "you"? Exactly what you were talking about.
Thank you very much. I spoke English, I'll speak again. Okay, now, ladies and gentlemen,
I've heard your question.
It's very simple, because to be honest with you, I don't like the way you just spoke to this guy. You said "use". Now, say what exactly
You don't like.
Yeah, because you're defining
my English was perfect. Anyway, listen.
Excuse me.
Manners. When one person is speaking, the other should be quiet. And you look like an educated person.
I'm not educated enough now that you have
your female friends in psychiatric care.
From this side, sir, I haven't even started answering your questions, sir. Okay, now from this side, you have one speaker. Okay, one person from that side, one person speak at one time. There's no need for two or three people to speak at the same time. Okay,
so the gentleman,
what happened was the gentleman came when we are already engaged talking about something. And he did not hear everything. Now, what the question here, let me say it again, okay? Now, I say it again, in this country, this beautiful country, Great Britain,
the one you hate,
the gentleman here is British, okay?
He hates England.
I said, in this country, there are millions of Christians who are the majority. In this country, there are millions of Muslims. In this country, there are many, many, many Jews. So I was said, in this country, how many of yous are here? When I say how many of yous, tell us, are you a racist? Are you a Hindu?
But as I said to you, allow me to finish.
I am saying I am a Muslim.
I just see everyone the same, men, women, everyone the same.
Yeah.
Everyone should have the same rights. Everyone should have, and that's
what you say. Actually, men and women cannot be same.
Why can't men and women be the same?
Can I finish? You said men are and women are same. Men and women are the same. Because when a man marries a woman, the man is the husband and the woman is the wife. Men and women cannot be same because when a man marries a woman, the woman, the lady, and the children cannot be same because a man marries a woman, the man is the husband, and the woman is the wife. Men cannot be a father, that's what he just said. Women are not same because look at our biology. Man is different from a woman.
Oh, well done. Even children know that.
Men and women are not same. Because a man is a man and a woman is a female woman. Okay.
A woman is a female woman.
My point was not about biology. My point was about rights.
Yes.
Men and women should have the same rights.
Okay.
Not they should have the same physiology.
It should just be insane.
Okay.
But you believe in a legal system that does not equate them.
I don't know.
No, under Sharia law.
You talk about the legal system. Let me tell you.
You were the one who
country, in this country, there are hundreds of Muslim barristers.
Allah.
You talk about a legal system. In this country, there are hundreds of Muslim solicitors. In this country, there are 13 Muslim members of parliament chosen at the ballot box. Why? Because they were good. Why? Because they were electable. Why? Because they were right. Why? Because they were the best.
But not because
in this country, in the House of Lords, you are Muslims who are lords sitting in the House of Lords.
They weren't chosen because they believed in Sharia.
Muslims are so good that Muslims are everywhere. In this country, you have Muslims in the Metropolitan Police Force. In this country, the
What about the divorce laws in Islam?
Divorce
can be with you.
Yes.
A man has to stand up.
Thank you very much, young lady. You changed the subject
three times.
He was fighting with me.
But the that doesn't mean exactly.
Okay. Well done. Well spoken. Let them answer.
Don't worry, you're not my boss, okay? The British don't need bosses. I mean, okay. Say again.
Speak. Females and men are not equal in Islam, because in Islam the divorce laws for a man say he can get up in front of friends and family and say, I divorced thee three times. Then they are completely divorced. For a woman, she could be killed if she tries to divorce her husband because he raped her or he tried to hurt her.
Where the have you heard that?
My child, I love you. You are my child.
Excuse me, she's old enough to be your daughter. What do you mean, love, love?
She's my child.
Even when he speaks, you know, he talks about women, about love and all.
What? She's talking
sense. Let me tell you. There are so many women's rights in Islam. For example, look.
Let me tell you.
You talk about divorce. Let me tell you.
In
Muslim countries, the divorce rate is very low. In your countries, the divorce rate is sky high.
Another thing.
As Muslims, or even Asians, let me tell you. As Muslims, when we marry a woman, it is for life. When you marry wife today, gone tomorrow. We Muslims, when we marry, we like to live. Let me tell you, madam, I'm the speaker, I'm now in my mood, so let me carry on. Allahu Akbar, Allah is the greatest. Let me tell you. We Muslims are so good.
No.
We Muslims, we are excellent. We Muslims, we are A1. Why? Why? Because we don't keep women as girlfriends.
Wife, yes, where is yours?
Where is yours? Okay? Now, don't be so personal. Let me tell you. Allahu Akbar. Allah is the greatest. And let me tell you the difference between a wife and a girlfriend. A wife, talk about your wife. And the difference between.
Tell us, what is the difference? You got so much weight.
Why don't you do jogging? Look at your weight. Allahu Akbar. We know how to. Look where his stomach is going. Come on.
Why are you passing?
You look like a woman, man. Dressed up in a man's clothing. Anyway, we Muslims, we know how to speak. We Muslims, we know how to debate. We know manners. Why? Our prophet, Muhammad, peace be upon him, he said, the best of you is the best in manners.
Oh, yes.
So, girlfriend, we Muslims, we don't keep girlfriends. We are wives. But people who give girlfriend what a wife is forever, a girlfriend is here today, gone tomorrow. A girl, wife forever, a girlfriend, maybe 1 week girlfriend, maybe 2 months, maybe 6 months. But let me tell you, we Muslims, wife, yes. In our lifetime, maybe our life will end, maybe with just one wife. But you guys, let me tell you, in your lifetime, maybe you might end up with 10, 15, 20, 30, 40, 50 girlfriends or boyfriends. Can you imagine? Now, people who say,
can't have more than one husband, but a man can have.
Yeah!
Okay. Women, okay, let me answer this one. Thank you very much. You're so nice. Why? You're giving me a chance to speak.
Come on. You are okay. Muhammad,
you're giving me a chance to speak. Now, lady, when a man marries a woman, husband and wife, yes?
Yeah.
One man, one wife. Okay, very good. Things are in order. Now,
okay.
Now you say, why can't a woman marry more than one husband? Let me tell you. If a woman, can I answer now? Can I answer? If
a woman can't marry more than one husband.
You're speaking Cockney, sir. Go back to the East End. What are you talking about? Go to the East End and speak Cockney. Anyway, sir.
That's not what I said.
Pardon?
Is that what you're saying?
Well, did I? No, don't put your words in my mouth.
Well, don't put your words
I have my own mouth,
mouth
and I can use my brain.
Why don't you answer this?
Allahu Akbar.
Why don't you answer
this? Side, from this side, one Muslim speaking. From that side, many people speak at the same time. Confused.com. Let's not let it be like that. Confused.com.
Oh,
anyway, ladies and gentlemen, let me answer you. But if a woman wants to have more than one husband, there'll be a problem. Why? Because one husband will say, let's go to Trafalgar Square. The other husband will say, no, let's go to Marks and Spencer's. So what will happen? How will they decide? If husband number one says, I want to have a baby, and husband number two says, I want one too. So what will they do? Toss a coin again to decide which one is going to be the father first. Come on, talk some sense.
Come on.
You have not answered her question.
Allahu Akbar.
You didn't answer her question.
If a wife doesn't want to have a baby, and then she gets pressured into having a baby and can't get a divorce, is that right? Is that equal? No. Because if the man has four wives and wants to have a children with every single one of them, fine, is it?
Can I answer that? Our Prophet, more than 1400 years ago, Hadith, our Prophet said, Muhammad, peace be upon him.
What do you say?
He said, I say what the Prophet said. I am nothing.
No wonder you're killing each other.
I am something because of Allah, because of the Prophet. Okay, now, otherwise I'm nothing. Who am I? Anyway, our Prophet, Muhammad, peace be upon him. Can I speak? Of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Our Prophet said, the best of you is the best to his wife. We are best to our wives. That's why our wives look, our divorce rate very low. Your divorce rate very high. We Muslims, when we marry, we are very confident.
But we know that.
But when you marry, no confidence. Why? Because you never know how long your marriage is going to last.
Happiness is priority.
Yes. But it is too much for him to understand.
Of course.
It's too much. Don't tell him.
He
wouldn't understand.
Yes, happiness in marriage. We Muslims, when we get married, we are happily, we live happily ever after.
Anyway. If the man gets unhappy, he'll just marry another woman.
Yeah.
Pardon?
If the woman gets unhappy, there's nothing she can do. But if the man gets happy, he'll just marry another woman.
Yeah.
No.
Oh, yes.
Okay, listen. Okay, a Muslim is allowed to have four wives at one time. Okay, let me explain to you. Okay,
You can't say that there's equality in Islam because that's bullshit.
No, you're not like me. What goes in the toilet shouldn't come out through the mouth. Listen, listen, young lady. What goes in the toilet?
Come on, don't be stupid.
What goes in the toilet? We British are stupid, so behave yourself, okay? Madam, what goes in the toilet should not come out through the
toilet. Why are you wearing these pajamas?
Allah, what are you talking about, bro? I'm busy talking here.
He said a woman can't marry four men, but a man can marry four women.
That's not
okay.
Good.
Do you want? Okay. Look, we Muslims, we use our brains.
Oh yeah.
And when we Allahu Akbar.
We use our brains to use our dick.
It's the wrong way.
We use our brains to use our dick.
Actually, this is Speaker's Corner. It is not Riot Corner. So listen to the speaker, please. Yes, a Muslim man can marry up to four wives at one time. But Allah says he has to treat them equally. Try to treat them equally. If he can't, then Allah says in the Holy Quran, in Surah Al-Nisa, Surah chapter number 4, verse 3, Allah says a man can marry up to four wives at one time. But if he can't treat them equally, then one is better. Let me tell you, if a woman wants to have four husbands, she's asking for a lot of problems. Why? Because husband number A will say, I want two children. Husband number B will say, I want six. Husband number three will say, I want one. Husband number four will say, I want five children. So in other words, a woman all her life, she will be going to and fro the maternity ward.
Mr. Speaker, you know why these people are here? They are here not to listen to your rubbish. They are here just to be entertained by me.
One wife.
I know.
Why do you claim the Muslim?
He doesn't know what we are talking about.
I do know what
you don't know what you're talking about.
I tell you what. When we say we British, and
British are not allowed to marry four wives in this country. You British are only allowed to marry one wife in this country.
Excuse me, are you a tourist?
No, I'm not a tourist.
So you don't need to tell us British, we know.
Well, I am educated enough.
Anyway, somebody asked a question. I was answering the question.
Yes, you got it wrong. I'm putting you right.
Okay, I'll tell you what. You people, instead of getting married, all you do is girlfriend.
Yeah, what's wrong with it?
All your life.
Oh, if only that were true.
What's wrong with it? Even a woman of 60 years, they say, yes, girlfriend. She's not a girl.
Even a man of
70 years, they say, boyfriend. Is a 70-year-old boy? Or is he an old man?
Boy!
I'm still a boy!
I'm still a boy!
Old boy! Yes, young boy, no!
Shame on you! Did you know our Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, he said, all mankind are from Adam
and Eve.
Well, he got that wrong as well.
Our prophet, who was an Arab, he said an Arab had no superiority
over a
non-Arab. And a non, I'm talking.
He had a 9-year-old wife, didn't he?
No.
Can I finish? Did you come here for a war or something? Speakers' corner.
Ben!
War corner.
Ben! Learn from these young people.
Learn. I'm old enough to be your uncle.
They are more intelligent than you are.
Anyway, our prophet said all humanity is from Adam and Eve. And our prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, who was an Arab. An Arab, he said, an Arab had no superiority
over
a non-Arab. And a non-Arab has no superiority over an Arab. Our prophet said a white person had no superiority over a black person. And a black person had no superiority over a white person. Our prophet said, accept through piety virtue. Why? Allah looks at the heart of a person. It doesn't look at the color of a person, at the ethnic group of a person.
If your Islam is so wonderful,
is an American,
then tell me, why are you killing each other?
Pardon?
If your Islam is so wonderful, then tell me, why are you killing each other? In Syria, in Iraq, in Saudi Arabia, in Iran.
I'll give you my glasses.
No, I don't need your dirty glasses.
I never killed nobody. So why you said, why are you killing? I never killed nobody. I am speaking.
But Muslims are killing Muslims.
Okay.
Why?
Thank you. Thank you for that question. Let me answer you.
Please answer. Don't refer any surah, yeah?
No, you will not see me run away.
No, we don't need that. You answer that.
I need it.
Yeah, no.
It gives me strength.
But don't tell me what Quran says. What Quran says.
Allahu Akbar. You want some questions? Let me finish.